So I'll just give you a brief intro about me. This is me, Gaurisha R. Srivastava, and I am an incoming software engineering intern at Microsoft for the next summer. And then, as I said, I am also one of the Google Generation Scholar for the year 2021. I was selected out of 29 different countries and among the top 70 students, or you can say scholars. And apart from this, I was also a mentee at a Microsoft Engage program this year and a winner at Hack the Earth Hackathon, right? So with this small intro, I'll move forward. So the agenda for today is going to be like this. We'll firstly talk about the scholarship, then we'll talk about the application process, the resume, essay, online challenge, meet and greet, and then finally we'll have a Q&A session. So let's begin. So now that we are talking about Google Generation Scholarship, it is important for us to understand what this program is and what are the aim for it and why one should apply to this. So for that, what I'll do is I'll quickly take you guys to the website of this program, right? And from there we'll move forward. So, as I said, this is a scholarship by Google given to some of the students who exhibit the best behavior that a person in the field of computer science can exhibit, right? It is actually given to those students who excel in the field of technology and who have the capability to be a leader for tomorrow, right? So with this being said, let's also talk about what this ex whole scholarship program is. So as I said, it is a scholarship program. So there is a scholarship amount that is going to be associated with it. So I'm sure that you guys, all of you are aware of this. So the scholarship amount for this scholarship is 1,000 USD. Now, when I talk about 1,000 USD, you should try to understand that this program is not just about the money. It is a lot more than just the money, right? So when I say it is a lot more than this, then I actually mean it. Now, why do I say this is? The very first reason, or you can say the perk that you get from the scholarship is you get to form a community with like-minded people. As I said, last year, 70 students or 70 girls from 29 different countries were selected in this program. And till date, we 70 girls are still connected to each other, and we talk about so many things and we have so many opinions that we share with each other. So it is a community that you develop out of the scholarship program. Now, after this community, if I talk about one of the most important, or one of the most enticing perk of this scholarship, it is the Google retreat that Google gives us. So before the coronavirus period, the scholars were used to be taken to the actual Google head offices at different places. Like as far as I remember, in the year 2018, students were taken to Australia Google office, and then they were also taken to South Korea Google office. But then as corona hit us, the 2019 batch, 2020 batch, and 2021 batch, we were not taken to such offices. But yes, we were given a virtual retreat. Now, when I talk about the virtual retreat, what it is a 2-day retreat where all the scholars, along with some of the best, or some of the greatest Googlers around the world, come together to explore new things in the field of technology. So after we got selected for the scholarship, we were invited to a virtual Google retreat where we had a 2-day sessions with some of the best speakers from from around the world, and we got to know about so many new things, new technologies, how Google handles different things, and a lot more things. And the best part out of it was that we were given the opportunity to interact with a Googler himself or herself. So that is one another perk of being a Google Generation Scholar. Then apart from this, if I talk about the other perk of the scholarship, then I would say that Google, actually what happens is Google, through this program, gives us tries to prepare us for so many things. After the scholarship, there was a complete roadmap that Google had prepared for us so that we can prepare ourselves for, let's say, technical interviews at Google, or, you know, how can we apply to some of the best positions at Google, being a software engineer or something like that. So in that roadmap, Google had organized so many, you know, technical sessions for us, coding sessions for us. And then Google had also, organized a mock interview for us, where we were given the exact same environment so that we can get the experience of how a Google interview goes. And I am sure that a lot of you must be, aspiring to be a Googler someday, to apply at Google and be a software engineer there. So, and I am also sure that you guys must be aware of what is the process of Google hiring. So this was something that Google, through this program, helped us with. They gave us the actual platform where we can actually understand how the Google hiring process occurs. So we were also offered some Google mock interviews, as I said. And then apart from this, we were given a very good set of resources through which we can prepare for not just for Google hiring process, but for other technologies as well, right? So these are just a few perks that I mentioned over here. The best part of this scholarship was the experience, as I said. So this was, being a Google Generation Scholar, it was one of the best experience that I ever had in my life. So with this said, let's move forward. And I just gave you a very small, perspective of what this scholarship program is. And I'll also just, take a minute to ask you guys to put up your doubts in the chat box as and when they come to you, that after the session, once we are done with this, we can take up your questions. I can take up your questions and address them. So, and also as I said, you should, ask them in the chat box as soon as you get there, so that you don't forget about it after the session gets over, right? So now, one more thing that I also had to, take up in this website was the application process. Now it is 100% sure, it is something which is obvious that all of you must have joined this session not just to know about my experience, but to understand the application process, right? So, and I was getting so many requests on LinkedIn and WhatsApp on what is the process, how should we prepare, and such things. So I'll try to answer all these questions here. And with this being said, let's move forward. So as you can see on your screen, this is the application process. And I'll walk you through each and every point. And with this, I'll also tell you about my process, what was different in my process. The application process this year is very much similar to what we had last year, with just one minor change, about which I'll tell you very soon. So the very first thing in the application process is general background information. So as soon as you click this application apply now button, you will be redirected to the application page, where there will be some questions related to your background information, your education and your university or college in which you are, and stuff like that. So this is something very minimal, and all of you can write about yourself as already, right? You must have prepared for some other scholarship or other programs as well.
So, mummy nahi aa rahi hu, ruk jao.
I would request all of you to mute yourself for the sake of the session, and with this I'll continue, right? So as you guys must have applied for some other programs other than this scholarship program or other programs, like I said, you must have applied through a form, right? So this general background information will contain all the common questions that are being asked into such application processes, right? Then we have very important component in the application process, that is the resume or CV highlighting technical CV, right? So now when I talk about resume and CV, I'll tell you a few things, not just with respect to the scholarship program, but in general, right? So resume is something which is very important for us students, because this is something which actually represents us in one page, right? I'll talk more about resume in the upcoming slides, but for now I'll move to the next step that you have to do in your application process. That is the transcript, which will also be asked in the application. And you can get your transcript from your university or college, as it is obvious, right? So in my case, I had my transcript already with me because I was also applying for Google Step internship. So my university had sent it to me, but you can ask your university or college for that. Then you are also supposed to submit an essay, essay to two short questions, right? Now these, this essay questions or your answer to the essay, that holds a very huge importance in your whole application. And I'll talk more about it as we go further with the session. But for now, I'll tell you what you are supposed to do right now, right? So as soon as you apply for this program, on clicking this apply now button, you'll have to mention your general background information, you'll have to add your resume, you'll have to add your transcript, and then you'll have to add the answers to the essay round. Now all these 4 points, these 4 points comprise of the first round of the whole application process. Now as you can see from the application process given in the website, there are, what I can perceive is there are three rounds. The very first round is all about your resume and essay round. Then the second round would be most probably meet and greet round, as you can see over here, and then a Google online challenge, right? Now, in my ear, the essay and the resume thing were same. There was no difference into that. And then I also had a Google's online challenge. But instead of this 15 minutes meet and greet, we had a video conversation round. It was a round that was supposed to last from 30 minutes to 35 minutes or 40 minutes. And then we were also told that this was not going to be a typical interview. It was going to be a video conversation, as I said. But in your case, we have 15 minutes meet and greet session, right? So we'll talk more about it as we move forward. And then we can also see from the application process, there are two essay rounds, essay questions. And one of the essay questions, that is the first question, it is the one that I had also written my essay about. It is the same question that I had received last year. But then the second question, that is something new. And as I said, as we will move forward, I'll tell you more about how you can write your answers, right? With this being said, the application process gets over here. So what you can understand out of this application process is there are going to be three rounds. The first round will be your resume and essay round. Second will be your 15 minutes meet or greet. And the third will be your online challenge. So it is also possible that the online challenge and the meet and greet round, they get shifted or upar niche ho sakte hain. It is possible that after your essay round you are invited for a online challenge and then the video meet and greet, and it is also possible that first you have the meet and greet session and then you have the online challenge. For this, what I would suggest is you wait for the official statement from Google after you submit your essay. Now, with this being said, I'll also draw your attention to the deadline, that is 10th September this year, 2021, right? So you have plenty of time. If we consider today's date, that is 2nd November, and then we consider the deadline, that is 10th December, you have almost 1 month and 8 days. That is more than sufficient. Now, as a applicant who is applying for this prestigious scholarship program, I would suggest that take the duration that you have in your hand very judiciously, right? You should not feel as if you abhi to ek mahina bacha hai. So what I can do is I'll start preparing for the application just 10 days before the deadline. This is not something which is recommended by anyone. You should not linger on till the last moment, because what will happen is once you start cultivating your essays and preparing for the further rounds, you'll realize that the time is actually very less. Even though it says almost 40 days, but that 40 days would seem less to you once you start preparing for it. So I would suggest, do not wait for the deadline to come, right?